Where are you going? white man said, get to the back. She said, I'm not moving, and that's a fact. Know what you say, what you can and can't do. It's all up to me, not up to you. And so Rosa Parks stood up for her rights. You should too, if you're black or if you're white. If you're out there, Rosa, we wanted to say, we thank you each and every day. You brought our country closer together. We'll never forget you. We'll love you forever.
Thank you. the leadership that we get from directors like Judith Foster and her whole staff.
Thank you. shorter than I am. But, let me lift it up.
All right.
The way we're going to do it is each poet's going to read two poems, and then if we have time, we'll do another round with one poem each. And keep going from there if we have more time. If you only have two here, I think I have some extras of your work. Again, thanks for coming. We're going to get started. We're going to do it alphabetically. So we'll start with Alani. Kendra.
My name is Kendra, and the first poem I'm going to read is called Stray Cat. It's about my cat. My cat, Stray Cat, walks with pride, where I live. Look closer, darting cold green eyes, fearless, ready for attack. Closer still, high-pitched, screeches, grabbing claws, terrified, scared of what lays beyond. Death, deepened horror in an instant. Death. My cat, Stray Cat, ready for attack. Memories of terror, walks with pride. Next poem we read is called Hidden Danger. It's about my dog. Quiet, cute, harmless, loyal, gentle, smart. Looks aren't everything. Too close, cross the line, leave alone. Big brown eyes turn to red dull creatures. Small cute snap tints of foaming wolf teeth. Beware, don't run. Oh, person will be angry, but you will try to climb again and ask for forgiveness. In this world, we wouldn't be anywhere without love.
This is my poem, not anyone else's. I guess you could say this is dedicated to my teacher, which is standing over there. I have a teacher, his name is Mark. He gives education a little spark. He gets us interested in any way. I enjoy coming to school every day. Even though we get lots of quizzes and tests, all I know is that his are the best. He is leading us to fortune and not to fate. I have a teacher, isn't he great?
Yay. My next poem is called 12. When you think about it in numbers, there are some dumber, but 12 is really smart. It is the awkward age for semi-teens, but what does this number really mean? Is it a dozen? Is it the amount of stoves on three electric ovens? Is it the chairs at the King's Round Table? Is it the best page in Grimm's Fairy Tale Fables? You'll never know, but it goes to show that 12 is a really great number. tonight. Back to you, Mark.
All right, who's never got a poem, come on up here. Haley. She's reading Annalisa's. Anna's not too happy about that, but she'll deal.
It's Annalisa's poem. You can all see her face right now. It's called Revenge. The necklace which clings to her pale neck falls in an explosion on the floor. A caring servant rushes towards the cry of his mistress and cautiously opens the door, just in time to see his mistress fall with a cry on her bed. Puzzled, he walks over and cries, "For the love of God, the princess is dead." He looks around and sees a figure. Turn around and bend. Excuse me, the bend. Hopeless, he mutters, "We'll meet again, my poor unfaithful friend."
Ooh. Wow. Ooh. Good one, Annalisa.
No return. It's the ghost of no sight. Fire. It's the sight of heat. It's the sight of orange coal. Water. It's the feel of nothing. It's the feel of air to the second power. Wind, fire, water.
Wow. Yilda.
From the world. Reach, reach, for nothing you do. Do you have a future? Sagging, here it is. What do? All the plant from our days. The plants round you wither and moan, and in the middle is a plant with a single beautiful flower. The brown leaves of your flower now dual pink sag with you, crying, weak petals curling.
I am the second Casey. I'm going to read a poem I wrote called Black Beauty. Actually, somebody else called Casey wrote it. Black Beauty. Black as ebony, bold as night, North Star shone bright upon his head. Runs with long, powerful legs, cute and bruised by hate. Cut and bruised by hate. United with his past, strays is in the fields he once grew up in. His hair swims in currents of wind, once so full of spirit, now as lifeless as a piece of driftwood beached on the shore.
About one of my heroes named Haywood Burns, and he's inspired me to be a lot of things and get into politics and stuff. When he died, I cried. went into a corner, laid my wet face on my arm, remembered. His beard, burly and wild, his face smooth and kind, his words wise and thoughtful, his eyes fiercely flashing, the lion's eyes. When he died, the hero I saw in him died too. I just want to say, he made a difference in his life, and I really want to make a difference in mine too.
Okay, I wanted to thank everyone for coming tonight, and hope to see many of you tomorrow at the graduation. It's been a great year, and the kids' poetry is really a manifestation of the parents and really the school's emphasis on writing from the grades up, and they're wonderful writers, so I love hearing it. So have a good night, and hopefully see you tomorrow.